Yep.
All right, welcome to Game Enthused. Have a game we'll play for Gianna's sister's Twisted Dreams. This game was kickstarted some months ago. I don't know what the total cost was. I never had a Commodore 64, but I was familiar with Gianna's sister's. Friend of a friend had a C64, and that was my introduction into it. I always thought it was really cool that there was something that somewhat of a Mario Brothers alternative. And I use alternative loosely. Obviously, the first one was not up to par with Mario Brothers, but I thought it was neat that it existed. So much so that I actually got the DS game when it came out not too long ago. And you see I did a couple of levels here. Let's see. Yeah, you'll forgive the less than stellar frame rate and the graphics not being quite as beautiful as they could be. My machine is not in any way new, so can't quite compete with a newer machine in terms of running this game. Somewhat surprised that I don't want to say a resource hog, but a little taken back from how slow it really did run with everything running high. Use the R. I'm using the 360 controller, the wired one. Use the right trigger to switch between the two sisters, who both have different abilities. So this sister can spin. Missed every single one of those. And I died. This is one spin, and the other sister can that was close. Let's turn herself into well, I guess she can kind of do a rush move, whatever. She can propel herself. Oh boy. You notice the music, the background, everything changes when you switch. So, the somewhat more emo looking sister has the brighter color background, whereas, I don't know. Not emo. I don't know how I would characterize his sister, but the preppier sister, no. She more of the fall looking colors, which look a little different. Even the title screen was different because I guess tomorrow is Halloween. The pumpkins and jack-o'-lanterns and stuff weren't there earlier, if memory serves. That's kind of cool. Change the some of the themes based on the date. So what I played with thus far, it looks really nice. It's fairly straightforward platformer. I can go on the blue water. Can't go on purple or green water. That much I do know. And you can see some of the gems and things are hidden from one sister, accessible by another. I guess I can't touch purple things because I just killed. I would have known that earlier. Also can't punch purple things, so the value lesson that is best to avoid purple things. Is that a severed hand down there? Sure looks like one. I can't get back up. Well. Okay, so. Am I missing something here? Oh, duh. Oh, I didn't die that time. I wonder why that happened. And the blue gems, either sister you can get. And I'm sure you recognize that the environment changes based on which one of the sisters you are. So, that dictates what you can interact with. Purple is still purple. Yeah, this frame rate could be better, but it's crazy that it takes a pretty decent machine to run this game and have it look really pretty. Well, that's a testament to how much work they put into it, so that's fine. And got them all. Nope, nope. Oh, crap. I really gotta stop doing that. No point doing that move because she can't get the red ones anyway, so. I do like that if you just use the powers, you'll just switch automatically, so you don't have to switch and then use the spin or the dash attack. You just. I'm over here, I just want to spin, so just turn into the other sister. Maybe I should know their names, but I don't know. Could. Well, originally, they were the great Gianna sisters. Clear alternative to the Super Mario Brothers, obviously. How am I supposed to get up there? I have no idea. No. Like I missed stuff down here too. Not maybe not. It's a really good looking game. Well, I guess I can't get that, so I'm sure I can, but I'm gonna move on. You just hold down the blue button, the X button to do that. That does it automatically. There's not a real wall jumping necessary. Yeah, you can still jump on heads. Still works. don't fall on the purple stuff. Just not very good at this. Okay, I hit the button that time. Come on. Okay, what? Where's the problem? I'm hitting the blue button. Nice. And the bodies stay for the reminder. Not really, I just want to say that. Now I'll just bypass this guy. Let's see. Gallery artwork. Nice. The inconsistency with the water is interesting. Interesting choice. Where am I supposed to be going? There we go. Real shame if I died right there. Switch. And that's the end of the level. And I died 12 times. Gotta do better. Okay, there's six worlds in each one. Six levels in each world. So you get toxic gas for one sister, and then what look like thorny vines or something, or tentacles for the other. Either way, it's not good. How can I get over there anyway? You know what? Just can't hold the button down on that one. Checkpoint. What is all this stuff over here? Fresh blue water. Thank you. come on. I missed that jump. Of course, I fall down. Oh, nice. I think I make that. Yeah, I'm going to avoid this guy entirely. Again. She can stand up? I thought that was like gas or something I couldn't stand on. Yeah, whatever. So even if the other sister is doing her dash move, the other one can pick up where she left off. Interesting. So like an endless loop in those platforms. can't do the dash move on him. And for whatever reason, couldn't do it right there. Checkpoint. Watch for the stepping. He had the dying in one hit most times, and inexplicably more than one. It takes two hits, so I don't understand why. There's no power ups or anything that I'm aware of. Like the signage lets you know, if you fall, you will die. No, you fool. They stop playing every platformer like Mario physics apply, because they don't. That was close. Areas that can be blocked off with some sister, with one sister and not the other. Imp or bird? Imp or bird? Imp. Oh, okay, I'll stop. Checkpoint real quick. No. I don't know how I'll do a lot at that point. Why didn't I start at the other checkpoint? Didn't open up for me for some reason. Now it's open. Okay, next time jump. And then switch sisters. There we go. I think you've probably seen me die enough in this game, but that was just two levels in the first world from the Gianna Sisters remake. It looks better than it in this video. I had to take the graphics down and some of the other effects down a notch in order to get it to run as well as it did, which isn't perfect or anything, but it's on Steam now, I think, for like 13-14 bucks. It's definitely worth picking up. And I believe it's coming to PSN and XBLA sometime next year. And you can always play the original Commodore 64 version. And there's a version of Gianna Sisters on the DS. Just about does it. Well, wait a minute. I can't even unlock this load if I wanted to play it. That'll do well enough. Jeez. Tough crowd. Anyway, GameOfThrones.com, podcast videos, handful of reviews. Have a good one.